Before this video gets started, I'd like to give a massive shout out to Terry and Avery Opticians for helping me out with my optical needs. Massive shout out to Terry and his son Harvin, two absolutely massive Charlton supporters. And if you guys are in any need of glasses, eye tests, eye checkups, anything like that, then Avery Opticians is the place to go and Terry is the guy to see. Massive shout out to you guys. So yeah, yesterday happened. What's going on, guys? Tylerowlinson here. And on Sunday evening, I hit 1,000 subscribers. What has honestly been an unbelievable journey. I honestly cannot believe I'm sitting in front of this camera and 1,000 people are on the other end of it. It's honestly unbelievable. I started the 2018-19 campaign, footballing season that is, with just 125 subscribers. Now I'm on over 1,000 and over 100,000 people have watched my videos. It's honestly unbelievable to think. All I can say is thank you. All I can say to all 1,000 of you is thank you so much for the support. It's honestly incredible. The fact that I've gone on this journey and I've gained this much following in such a short space of time is genuinely unbelievable. So to celebrate me hitting this absolutely unbelievable milestone, I've decided to do another Instagram Q&A. I've done this before for 500 subscribers, which was back in March, by the way. So we've managed to gain 500 more in the space of 3 months, which is quite insane. But yeah, if you want to feature on the next Q&A, feel free to follow me on Instagram. It's on the screen over here. I asked for questions yesterday, and I said to ask me them quick if you want a chance of featuring. And my God, did you guys ask me a lot of questions? You sent in yours quickly. So I've picked the best 20 and I'm going to be answering them now. Apologies if I didn't get around to answering your question. It even means that you've asked me more than one question, which I've only picked out one of the questions that you've asked me, because otherwise it wouldn't really be fair on everyone else. Either your question has already been answered or already been asked, or I just haven't had time to answer it. So if I haven't answered your question, let me know on Instagram and I will answer them for you over there. So the first question comes in from Jack Rodwell 12, and he asks, what player would you bring back to Charlton not from last season? So obviously I can't bring back Bauer, unfortunately, and I won't be able to bring back Aribo either, because of course Aribo is about to go to Rangers and Bauer's just joined Preston. Nick Pope would be up there, maybe. Adamola Lookman, probably. Johan Burt Gudmundsson. Joe Gomez. Yeah, there's a lot of players. There's a lot of players I could probably bring back, but if I had to choose out of them lot, I'd probably go with Lookman or Gomez. I'd probably go one of them too, because of course they're young, promising lads, and of course Gomez is now a Champions League winner, so I'd love to have them back at the squad. Next question comes in from Joe Cooper 01, and he asks, who do you want Charlton to sign? Now, like, let's be real here. Charlton need a hell of a lot of additions during this window. We know we're going to have a small budget. We know that Bowyer's got a lot to work with, and he's got a lot of work to do. But who do I want to sign? Personally, I'd like to see Oztuma join us. Reportedly, he's going to be signing for the Addicts today, so it looks like that deal's going to go through. So you're going to see another Addicts additions episode very soon. I think we're likely to get Tom Lockyer. I'm not too sure about that one yet. Of course, a centre back, Welsh international. I'd have to look into him if we are to get him in. But the one player I'd love to see at Charlton is Eddie Nketiah from Arsenal. If we can try and book him on loan, that is an absolutely brilliant signing. Him and Taylor up front, or possibly Macaulay Bon, if Taylor doesn't perform, honestly would be brilliant. I genuinely think that if we can get Nketiah, it would be an unbelievable signing. But we need a hell of a lot more. We need a left back as well. I think we need a goalkeeper. We're interested in Ben Amos, who I think we might get as well, from Bolton. We need a couple more central midfielders. I'd love Cullen and Bielik to stay, obviously. Next question comes in from Ben_J, and he asks, where do you think Charlton will finish this season? At the moment, personally, I think we're going to get relegated, no questions asked. We've not got enough players in our squad. Some of them are like youth academy quality. Some of them don't have the experience at championship level. We need to sign quite a lot of players. But if the takeover, hope and praying that it does, but I'm not really paying attention to it anymore because I can't be asked to. If it is to go through and Boya can get the players he wants, I think we could finish lower end mid-table. I think we could do it. I think we could stay up. But next question comes in from Charlton_FC_402, and he asks, what is your greatest achievement? I don't know if you mean to do with YouTube or personal terms, but I'd say for YouTube, obviously, 1,000 subscribers, that is genuinely unbelievable, and I can't believe I've landed this milestone. Personal terms, probably passing all of my GCSEs. That 100% was definitely a good achievement. Next question comes in from my friend Charlotte. Shout out to you, Charlotte. And she asks, who's the best in our group? In brackets, be brutal. I can't exactly be brutal, unfortunately, because, of course, it is a personal matter. Of course, you lot are my friends, and I can't really talk about our personal matters on YouTube. So, I guess we'll just meet in the middle and say that I'm the best. Next question comes in from I_its_chi. I probably butchered that, sorry. But he asks, will we beat Millwall this season? I am hoping to God that we do, because it's been since 1996 that we've beaten them. And they always give it the big and personally, I mean, knowing them, they're probably going to get 6 points against us this season, which I won't really mind, to be honest, because we're probably going to finish above them anyway. So, I mean, they can have their 6 points against us. We're going to finish above them in the league anyway. Next question comes in from Claude.Wilduck. I've butchered that again. And he asked, how do you think Macaulay Bond will do and how much will he play this season? Now, if you've seen my Addicts Editions video, you will know that I'm not particularly, like, I'm even Stevens within, like, he's a good player, he's a promising lad who's scored a bunch of goals at National League level but has never played above League 2 level before. Personally, I'd like to see how he does in pre-season, and if he can deliver, then hopefully he'll do all right in the Championship. Me, personally, I don't think he's going to do as well as people probably would expect, or as he would expect. I think he'll probably play, he'll make a few appearances. He'll definitely start cup games and things like that, but league games, I'm hoping he can deliver, because I'm hoping it's going to be 200k well spent. But I don't know. I think mixed emotions about Bond. I think he might do all right, might do really bad. Next question comes in from Harry Gear, and he asks, would you like Cullen and Bielik to stay? Do you think Cullen and Bielik will stay? It's a tough one, because I would absolutely love them to stay. But of course, Cullen sees his future at West Ham, even though West Ham have just spent like 24 million on Fornals, a central midfielder. So Cullen's game time is immediately being cut again. I think personally Cullen is going to make at the maximum West Ham bench and start cup games, and that's it. So I think it'd be worth Cullen to come back to us so he could get game time. As for Bielik, he said himself that if he doesn't get a professional contract at Arsenal for the first team, he's going to leave. And I think if he is going to leave, I think that we should 100% try and snap him up, because the season that he's had with us this last year, the season just gone, was absolutely unbelievable. And I definitely think that Bielik would be brilliant. We are going to miss both of them if we don't sign them, but I would love them to stay. Next question comes in from Alex_C2201, and he asks, if football wasn't a sport, what would your favourite sport be? I honestly can't even imagine a world where football wouldn't be a sport. I don't actually know what I'd do with myself. But this is a fairly easy one, really. I think my favourite sport, if football wasn't a sport, would probably be motorsport. I followed Formula One for years. Of course, I did a vlog last year when I was out in Belgium for the Formula One. One of the best experiences of my life. Genuinely unbelievable. Couldn't believe I was actually there. Next question comes in from Jess_Parker05, and she asks, who's the most annoying brother? Both of them. Next question comes in from A_Cuevas76. Again, I've probably butchered that. I sincerely apologise. And they asks, what all-time player would you have at Charlton? Any position? All-time player. I'd probably say Clive Mendonca. He's got to be my favourite player of all time. Favourite Charlton player of all time. Brilliant striker. I would love to have him back in our team now. Mendonca, unbelievable striker. Quality player. Next question comes in from CAFC_fan_page. And he asks, Palace or Mill Ballsack? You have to answer. Probably Mill. Next question comes in from vlogger Super Sadler Seb. He's a Walsall vlogger. Be sure to check him out. He's agonizingly close to 400 subscribers. So if you can get him to that milestone, that would honestly mean the world to him. And he asks, what made you start new YouTube? Now, I did touch upon this in my 500 subscriber Q&A, but I'll touch upon it again because it's been a while since I've mentioned it. Basically, like, I've always been interested in football vlogging. I've always seen it as a really good idea. I watched the likes of Spencer FC, Bazinga and Fogden and all those stuff before I'd even thought about starting. And I thought that with these guys doing it, I thought that maybe there was someone with Charlton doing it. And there was. I found Jamie Boxall, who, if you don't know him, he of course works with the club now. He used to do match the vlogging. He doesn't do vlogging anymore. I definitely consider him as an inspiration for me to do it. And then, of course, I decided to give it a go, and here I am today, not regretting a single minute of it, now on 1,000 subscribers. Question comes in from MXR217, and he asks, are you known for YouTube in school? Yes, unfortunately, I am, yeah. Quite a lot of people, quite a lot of my friends know, obviously, as you would probably imagine. There are a couple kids in my school in like lower years who know who I am. Some teachers even know, like some English teachers, and my Spanish Spanish teacher I think knows as well. So next question comes in from Cholton_R_the_best. Great username, by the way. And he asks, are you going to all pre-season games? At the moment I think I'm going to Welling, Ebbsfleet and Aston Villa. Not too sure about the other three, like Gillingham, Colchester and Dagenham and Redbridge. Probably not going to be going to them. But it looks like I'm going to Welling, possibly Ebbsfleet and more than likely Aston Villa. I don't know yet. I'll probably let you know closer to the time. But yeah, if I do end up going and you see me whilst in those preseason games, feel free to say hello. Next question comes in from R1.Riley and he asks, should Johnny Williams stay? Now, not going to lie, Williams, like, the best I saw Williams play was the playoff final when he played for us. Like, he was absolutely instrumental when he played. But I have to be honest, like, Johnny lacked end products last year. He lacked a lot of end products the season just gone. Didn't score, didn't get an assist. He was a technically good player, but sometimes he was too good for his own boots. Like, he overdid it sometimes. But, like, me personally, I would love Johnny to stay. I think he would be a good player in the Championship, of course. We haven't offered him a contract, but Johnny's not found a club yet. Like, Swansea were reportedly going to offer him a contract, and I think Luton were interested as well as Brentford. But the door is still open. Like, Johnny is still available for us to sign him. But I think when Johnny's contract expires, we're probably not going to get him in time because Williams' wages is really high, and we're probably not going to get him for that reason. I would like him to stay, but it's not likely because his wages are too high. But if he is to stay, I'd 100% take him back at Charlton. Next question comes in from LewisK2009, and he asks, how long do you think Charlton will stay in the Championship for? Now, as I said, at the moment, I can see us getting relegated because, like, our squad at the moment isn't good enough because we've got, like, 14 first-team players. Of course, that was increased with Jake Forster-Caskey signing a new deal, which is fantastic news. This season is all about rebuilding the club. We've got to rebuild our team again because we've lost practically half of our squad from last year. So I'm hoping that we could. I'm hoping we can stay up. If we stay up this season, I think we'll probably stay in the Championship for maybe another 3 or 4 years until it gets a bit too much for us and we may go down. And who knows? We could be promoted, but I don't know. I think it's going to be tough for us to stay out this year. We know what season we're going to be in. We're going to be in a struggle this year. I can see us being in like a relegation scrap, lower end of the table. Our next question comes in from CAFC Media, who is, of course, Millie Edmondson, fellow Charlton vlogger. Be sure to check her out. Great vlogger. And this is actually quite relevant, actually, because she asks, what other vloggers do you enjoy? Now, I watch quite a lot of matchday vloggers, of course. I watch Millie, of course, as well. And, of course, quite a lot of other match of vloggers from other clubs. Of course, I watch Fogden, Stump Peg, Super Sadler Seb, Cod's Vlogs, Ben Natman, of course, SHD, Sam Drake, Olivia Bantams. I'm trying to think of more on top of my head. I can't really do it. Man Mistake, Wee Philly, Jam Sarni, Macam FC. There's a lot. Like, I watch quite a lot. I can't really think of more on top of my head. Alex Craig and Sky Blue Tube, that's another one as well. I watch them quite regularly as well. Tykes TV and Taylor Carrington, now Barnsley vlogger. But yeah, I watch quite a lot of Blanchard vloggers now. I enjoy all of them, really. Next question comes in from Jordan_J20, and he asks, will we survive without our lone midfielders and Joe Aribo? Now, of course, lone midfielders referring to Josh Cullen and Christian Bielik, and of course, Joe Aribo leaving to Rangers. Now, I have to be honest, our midfield was 100% one of the best, if not the best area of the pitch for Charlton. Our midfield absolutely bossed the season. They were unbelievable. Like, every single one of them. Bielik, Cullen, Williams, Aribo, bloody Reeves, Prattley, they were all brilliant. Lapsley and Morgan as well. Half of them have moved on now, of course. Of course, Rebo will move on. But it's going to be tough to replace them. Like, especially replacing Rebo is going to be really tough. Reportedly, we are signing Osthuma today, which, of course, I think is a good signing. But it's going to be tight. It's going to be tough for us, personally, to fix the midfield area. The final question of the video is CAFC underscore Ronnie underscore Tiller underscore 10. And he asks, this isn't a question, but you deserve more than 3k subs. Thanks a lot, mate. But honestly, you're too kind. No way in hell I deserve that many subscribers. Like, what I'm on now is great, but 3k I think is a little bit too ambitious. And we're going to end on that positive note. Thank you to everyone that's asked me questions. Again, apologies if I didn't get around to answering the question. If I didn't answer your question, feel free to let me know on Instagram and I'll answer it to you over there. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, can you possibly leave a like, subscribe if you're new around here, and turn those post notifications on so you're notified of when I post. Honestly, guys, thank you so much again for 1k subs. That is genuinely unbelievable. I wanted to reach this milestone by the end of the season, and we've managed to do it. By the start of the season, sorry, and we managed to do it before pre-season's even begun. So genuinely can't wait for this season. It's going to be a hell of a roller coaster. Thank you so much again for helping me pass this milestone. Next stop is 2K. Who knows when we're going to get that? This has been Tyler Rowlinson. Have a nice day, and I will see you all in the next video. Thank you so much, guys.